Welcome back to Who Chose. Today on Who Chose, I'm going to be releasing my latest 3D printable modular tower hydroponic system. About a month ago, I released a injection molded physical modular tower hydroponic system on the Hydroland website. And we did a complete grow from seedling through to mature plant and got a really fantastic result. Now, the reason I wanted to design a 3D printable version of that system is because it's kind of really inefficient to ship a large bulky system like that. The system itself is cheap to buy. I think it's like $140 on the website, but you'll get hit with shipping because it's such a large bulky item that the shipping cost is just phenomenal. This is exactly the situation that lends itself to 3D printing. Hyperlocal manufacture utilizing cheap filament is perfect for this scenario. And looking at it from an environmental and sustainability standpoint, it just makes sense to make it available as a 3D printable file for you to print at home incredibly cheap. I'm talking $4 a section. And this is also going to help the people that have purchased on the Hydroland store the original system, because it is compatible with the injection molded system. If you wanted, you could just add 3D print sections to the injection mold. Let's talk about the 3D prints. Over the last couple of months, I've been working on transforming the injection molded parts into something that we can 3D print. It's actually been quite easy because of the way that these have been injection molded. They lend themselves really nicely to be printed without supports on 3D printers. However, I did need to design some brand new components like this. This is the base, which will allow our tower to be connected to a base. Obviously, you can't 3D print a whole reservoir, so we're going to be using store-bought reservoirs, whatever you have available in your area, to mount this entire system. Let me show you the different parts involved. Breaking the tower down, there are essentially three main sections that we need to recreate as a 3D printable object. The tower sections themselves, which I've designed to be 3D printable without supports. So they will just print straight on your bed, probably even fit on an Ender's bed, but they definitely fit on the 256 by 256 bamboo beds. The footprint of all of these prints is 192 by 192. So that means that you should be able to print them on many other printers, including the old Enders. I print with 15% infill. You can ramp that up, and the ratio you land on between 15% and 100 is gonna dictate the price of each part. So each of these sections at 15% is going to weigh 360 grams. So if you're getting your print filament at $12 a kilo, this is gonna cost about $4.40 to print. It is actually quite a budget-friendly way of getting extra sections for your existing towers. For those who aren't so handy but do have a printer, purchasing the base and reservoir from Hydroland and using these sections to extend your existing tower may be a budget-friendly option for you. And these are interchangeable. I've designed them to work with the old injection molded parts, which was actually quite difficult to do when you're designing with tolerances for 3D printing and injection mold. That was the real challenge that existed here. The next part is the top dispersal section, essentially. So that's what it looks like after months of use. So we have that designed here and the lid that goes on top. Now, I've actually changed the design since to give it more structural support so that it doesn't curl up in the sun. And that will fit onto the top of our 3D printable sections. For the base, I've designed a compact footprint base, which looks like this, and a wider footprint base, which looks like this. So I've actually been so impressed with the way that this system turned out that I've done a production run of the bases so that I can supply these to people that don't have 3D printers that are interested in adapting the injection mold system to a larger base reservoir. These will be available on the Hydroland website as soon as I can get them down to the distribution warehouse. So when I designed this base, I designed it with a 1/2-inch BSP screw at the base because I wanted it to be adaptable to the most things by the most people. That means that you can adapt a hose nipple and BSP screw into the base and quick connect directly to a hose, which then connects up to a pump. Now, I'm hearing all the 3D printers say, why didn't you just 3D print that part? I have. So, this will also be available on my Patreon. This is a BSP to quick connect, and you just add in a quick connect O-ring. These are available on the Hydroland website, or you can just rob them off your other fittings. Quick connect fittings are really cheap. And it just screws into the base like so. Now, to do with all the tolerances are tight though. So any elephant's foot will make it very hard to fit these pieces together. I've made them with a 0.1 millimeter tolerance and they fit perfectly with the generic PET G Bamboo Lab settings. For the base, I'll be using these. These are handy storage, 35 liter storage barrels. They are BPA free and food safe. The only downside is that they're slightly see-through. So we'll be doing something to cover these up to protect the nutrient from the light. The reason that I like these barrels is that rather than clipping on, the lid screws on. And that means that it's gonna be extremely stable once we have 35 liters of nutrient in our reservoir. So the first thing we're gonna do is set up our lid. This is where we're going to mount our tower. We have to cut the handle out first. Like that. And now we're just going to mark out where we want our holes for our base. So the fixing points have all been designed with an M8 bolt in mind. Bolt and washer, essentially. That's an 8 millimeter hole we've got to make. And we've also got a center hole here for our tap fitting for our quick connect. The hole layout looks like that. So we'll use hole saws for the big holes and just a Christmas tree bit for the small holes. Like so, and you can do a better job of the hole layout than I did. And we can just screw our quick connect fitting into the base. Like so. And I've just put a couple of little holes in the base section so that if this fills up with water, it drains through. To light block this container, use alfoil. The way that we're gonna stick the alfoil onto this container is this. This is Sika Spray Fix. It's just a spray on glue essentially. And put our alfoil onto the surface of our container. That worked incredibly well. And we've even got our leader markers. We have no light anymore except for where, you know, our leader marker indicator is. So you can see the difference that that alfoil has made. And where the leader markers are, I'm also gonna put a hole in the side for my float valve. Like so. And this is going to allow us to have a larger reservoir connected up to this reservoir. Using just an elbow float. And that will keep us topped up to about 25 liters. We can just add in quick connect, and now we have a refilling light-proof container. We'll just be using the cheap Hydroland pumps. I think these are about 25 bucks. They're well and truly strong enough. In fact, I think this is gonna be too strong for the requirements of the system. So to the top of that, we just adapt in a BSP fitting, which is the same size as the one that fits in the base of this 3D print. So theoretically, you could just screw this 3D print into this pump. And that's going to save you two fittings. We just adapt that to that. And then a piece of hose, the depth of the reservoir that goes between the top and the pump. And as you can see there, I've just made a slit and a hole for the cord to slide through, and it doesn't interfere with the twisting of the screw-on lid. I can place the pump down, and I'm going to stick that to the bottom over the side so that it doesn't interfere with our float valve. And you can see our pump at the bottom isn't interfering with our float valve. And to the top of that, our tower sections just slot in. How good? And all we have to do now is connect it up to a nutrient reservoir or refill the nutrient and just use this reservoir. This is my NFT, and I have a spare 13 millimeter feeder coming off it. So I'm just gonna connect this up to our float valve and turn this line on, and that will start filling the reservoir. As you can see here, the water level's just over 20 liters. That's great. Filled up with the nutrients from my NFT reservoir, which is feeding all of the rails here. And I've just got an offtake coming from the NFT, and it's just filling up. So this is perfect for leafy greens, essentially. And I'll just give you a quick look. In the NFT, I've got a bunch of spring onion. These are actually red onion that I've been trialing, and you can see that they're actually doing not too bad. Basil. We've got a bunch of Salanova lettuces. It's a little bit haphazard at the moment. I've let it go a little bit, but it's still producing for me, which is fantastic. Instead of going into the end of my NFT, there's an extra offshoot, and it's gonna shoot into this, which is gonna have leafy greens as well. So it'll be the perfect EC and PH. So let's plug this in and see how it runs. I reckon this is gonna shoot up, because this is gonna be a way more powerful pump than it's designed for. Yeah, look at that. That's so powerful. Okay. And you can see there how it works. We just put the lid on. That should stop it, hopefully, unless it just forces the lid off. Yeah, there we go. How good. And that is going to, yeah, have a look at that. It's like floating the lid off. I might need to put a tap into that. That's crazy. So you're gonna need a variable pump. Yeah, I'm gonna need to adjust that pump power down. But there's more than enough pump power there to get you as high as you need to go. So I'm actually gonna change the pump out. This is the pump that I really should recommend for this system. This is the one that goes with the original, the injection molded system, but we sell these separately on Hydroland. Obviously, you can just put a tap in that and turn down the pump volume, so you can do it with any pump. But this one has a power control on the actual AC adapter, and it also has an inbuilt timer, so you can cycle it on and off. So I'm just gonna swap this pump out. And as you can see, that adjustable pump is working. An absolute treat. Fantastic. And there it is. That is the new 3D printable modular tower hydroponic system. All of the files for this print are on my Patreon, and I want to thank my Patreons again for supporting me and allowing me to spend the time creating 3D printable models like this to share with the world. So, happy hydroponicking, happy 3D printing, and I will see you next time on Who Chose.